So here we are finding average power of a random process. That will also give us the relation between power and power spectral density. Okay. So what is that relation here? We have average power of a random process x of t, which is wide sense stationary. The random process whichever we have taken is wide sense stationary. So it says that the average power p x x will be equal to the time average of the second movement. What is the second movement? It is expected value of x square of t. Okay. So how do you find out time average? It is limit t tends to infinity 1 by 2 t integral minus t to plus t expected value of x square of t dt. This is the formula to find out time average. Okay. So this will give us what? This gives us the average power of a random process. Okay. And what is the another statement says that the Pxx, the power, it also can be obtained from the autocorrelation function by substituting tau is equal to 0. So Pxx is equal to Rxx of tau, where tau is equal to 0. Okay. So we know that autocorrelation function is inverse Fourier transform of the power spectral density spectrum. So what is the power spectral density? It is given as 1 by 2 pi integral x s x x of omega e power j omega tau d omega. Substitute tau is equal to 0 here. So it is given as 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity to plus infinity s x x of omega d omega. This gives us the power of a random process. Okay. These are the two statements we use to obtain the power. Okay. Now we prove this by, we'll be proving this here. Okay. What is that? The power can be obtained from limit t tends to infinity 1 by 2 t integral minus t to t expected value of x square of t dt. Like this we can find out the average power over t tends to infinity. And the average power can also be obtained from this. Pxx is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity to plus infinity s xx of omega d. Okay. So this gives us what is the relation between power and power spectral density. Okay. Now we are proving this here. To prove this, what is that we have done? X of t is wide sense random process. Now to apply Fourier transform, we obtain xt of t in the interval minus t to plus t. Okay. What is xt of t is equal to x of t in the interval minus t to plus t. Okay. Now we apply Fourier transform to xt of t. What is xt of t is xt of omega is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity xt of t e power minus j omega t dt. This is the formula for Fourier transform. Okay. Now what we know that xt of t is equal to x of t in the interval minus t to plus t, yes or no? So integral minus t to plus t xt of t is equal to x of t e power minus j omega t dt. Okay. So from this, now we know that from the Pascal's theorem, we can obtain the energy. Energy will be implied to minus given at integral minus infinity to plus t, minus t to plus t mod xt of t square dt is equal to what? 1 by 2 pi integral minus t to plus t mod xt of omega square d omega. Now we are finding the average power in the interval minus t to plus t. Okay. So the average power we denote it as P of t is equal to 1 by 2 t into the energy. What is the energy? Energy we got from this equation. Okay. Substitute that. So it is integral minus t to plus t mod x t square of t dt is equal to what? 1 by 2 pi integral minus t to plus t mod xt of omega square by 2t d omega. Okay. Now what is that? We got average power in the interval minus t to plus t. Okay. Now we have to find out the power, the total power, the power in the interval minus infinity to plus infinity. We want to find out the power from minus infinity to plus infinity. What is that here? T tends to infinity. Okay. The average power of a random process in the interval minus infinity to plus infinity we denote it as Pxx. Okay. So how do you find out average power? The average power of a random process when t tends to infinity is equal to the mean of p of t. Okay, so the average power is equal to what? It is mean of p of t where t tends to infinity. If t tends to infinity, we'll be finding what is that? It is the average power of random process x of t is equal to what? It is the mean of p of t as t tends to infinity. Okay. So what is pxx now? Pxx is equal to what? Pxx is given as limit t tends to infinity, t value is tending to infinity, 1 by 2p. See here. Now we apply what is that mean to this equation. So 1 by 2t integral minus 2 to plus t, it is expected value of xt square of t dt. We are applying mean to that, mean to this equation. Okay. Similarly, this equation can be written like this. It is limit t tends to infinity. Okay, 1 by 2 pi integral minus t to plus t. Okay. Xt of omega. Apply expected value here. Expected value of xt of omega square by 2t dt. So any doubts here? We are just, what is pxx? Pxx is nothing but the mean of p of t as t tends to infinity. Now we apply mean, expected value to this equation. So what is that we get? So limit t tends to infinity 1 by 2t, expected value of x of t square dt we get. Here also we get expected value of x of t of omega square by 2t we get here. Okay. Now we will just take this equation, the first equation. From the first equation, what is this equation says? It is nothing but pxx is equal to what? It is limit t tends to infinity 1 by 2t integral minus t to plus t. Here we have a function, expected value of x square of t dt. Okay, what is this? This is the formula for time average of expected value of x square of t. This is the time average of expected value of x square of t. So it is satisfying the first statement. What is the first statement? The first statement is that average power pxx is equal to time average of its second movement. Okay, so it is satisfying the first statement. Okay. Now we'll take the second statement. You take this. So pxx is given as, okay, now limit t tends to infinity we apply to this term. So 1 by 2 pi, t is tending to infinity, no? So it is integral minus infinity to plus infinity, limit t tends to infinity, expected value of mod xt of omega square by 2t d omega. Okay, now if power spectral density R xx of omega is defined like this, limit t tends to infinity. If power spectral density formula is given like this, xt of omega square by 2t. This is the formula for power spectral density. Then what is your pxx? Pxx is nothing but 1 by 2 pi. So it is 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity to plus infinity s xx of omega d omega. This is the formula for pxx. Okay, what is this formula? This is the formula for autocorrelation function when tau is equal to 0. So what is your pxx? Pxx is equal to autocorrelation function when tau is equal to 0. So the average power pxx is autocorrelation of x of t at tau is equal to 0. Like this, we will be satisfying both the statements of power, average power. Average power of a random process is equal to what?
The average power of a random process is equal to time average of the second movement of the random process. Or the average power is also defined that is equal to autocorrelation function when tau is equal to 0. This is the second statement. Like this, we can obtain the average power of a random process.